You know, you go to American films, they're all these zombies, you know, and zombies become this kind of treacherous, threatening figures. They're objects of fear. But in Haiti, people may be not afraid of zombies, but rather afraid of being zombified themselves. So the fear is not of being harmed by a zombie, but the fear is of being zombified themselves. Why? Because zombification is a way of punishing members of the community that have done things that cannot be reached by the law. So if you do some harm to someone in your community, but that harm cannot be touched by the existing laws, then you could go to one of the secret societies. Some of the secret societies, the best known is the Bizango societies. And these secret societies will adjudicate justice in the community. So within that adjudication of punishment for harm done to others, zombification is the equivalent of capital punishment. And what it is not a magical process. There is a zombie recipe. You can put together your elements. It's a poison, if you want to think of it as such, that can be administered through the skin, for example. And what it does is it paralyzes the nerve system. So you appear to be dead while you are indeed alive. You are so aware of what is happening around you, even though you cannot move. So it's a combination of impotence and complete awareness. So for Haitians, however, when you put together that trauma, that pharmaceutical trauma, with religious belief, is when you get the total effect of the punishment that zombification means. Why? Because if you are a believer in Vodun, you believe that one of the components of your soul, the petit bonange, holds your willpower, your ability to decide for yourself. And during zombification, when they come and get you out after they bury you, the bokor, the priest, will capture your petit bonange in a bottle. And your willpower is then sealed under someone else's control.